Hi everyone, I am Professor Shalini. Now let's move towards the next concept of SI engines. The next concept is the design of combustion chambers. Okay, while designing the combustion chambers, we have to know that it has great impact on engine performance or knocking tendency of an engine. Okay. Hence, while designing any combustion chamber, different factors has to be taken in consideration. Okay, which are that factors? Suppose shape of combustion chamber or size of combustion chamber is taken in consideration. We have to also decide the location of different parts on combustion chamber. For example, spark plug or deposition of inlet or exhaust valves. This is taken in consideration. Okay. Now we will see different requirements of an SI engine combustion chamber. Okay, what are different requirements by combustion chamber? It is to provide high power output with minimum octane requirement, high thermal efficiency and smooth engine operation. Now we will see one by one. Smooth engine operation. As we all know, smooth engine operation requires a moderate rate of pressure rise during combustion. Okay, that is absence of detonation, which multiplies a compact combustion space with short distance of flame travel. Okay, hence the aim of any engine design is to have smooth operation and good economy. This can be obtained by moderate rate of pressure rise during combustion. The pressure rise during combustion must be moderate or absence of detonation. Okay, now we will see compact combustion chambers. Short distance of flame travel from sparking plug to farthest point in combustion space, pocket in which stagnant gases may collect, should be avoided. Due to this, smooth operation of engine takes place. Now we will see next. That is reducing possibility of knocking. How possibility of knocking can be reduced? By proper location of spark plug and exhaust valve. Okay, again, satisfactory cooling of spark plug points. Okay, to avoid pre-ignition, we do cooling of spark plug points because pre-ignition can be avoided by this. Okay, again, cooling of exhaust valve head. Okay, this is hottest region on combustion chamber. Reduction in possibility of knocking in an engine can be achieved by reducing the distance of flame travel, by centrally locating spark plug, and by avoiding packets of stagnant gases. We want to locate the spark plug at the center of combustion chamber. Due to this, the flame will travel equal distance, and due to this, different pockets of stagnant charges will not be created in combustion chamber. Okay, again, as I have explained, satisfactory cooling of spark plug and exhaust valve area, as exhaust valve area is the hottest region of combustion chamber. Third, reducing the change temperature of last portion of charge. Okay, through application of high surface to volume ratio in that part where last portion burns. Okay, now we will see next factor. That is high power output and thermal efficiency. We know when high thermal efficiency, which in turn requires high compression ratio. Compression ratio required is high, and a small heat loss during combustion, which means small surface to volume ratio is required. Okay, a small heat loss during combustion, this is achieved by compact combustion chamber, which provides small volume to surface ratio. By compact combustion chamber, we obtain small surface to volume ratio, and due to this, heat loss decreases. Okay, what is the advantages of this combustion chamber? Also, the reduced flame travel. Flame travel distance is reduced with a given turbulence. This reduces the time of combustion. Okay, and due to this, combustion time loss decreases. Okay, high power output and thermal efficiency. This can be achieved as follows. How we can obtain high power output and thermal efficiency? A high degree of turbulence is needed to achieve high flame front velocity. High turbulence is required, okay? As we high turbulence is provided, it increases the rate of burning and reduces detonation tendency. Detonation tendency get decrease here as turbulence increases. Turbulence is induced by inlet flow configuration or squeeze. Squeeze is rapid radial movement of gas trapped between the piston and cylinder head into the bowl or dome. Squeeze can be induced in SI engines by having bowl in piston or with dome shaped cylinder head. We will see next factor that gives us high power output and thermal efficiency, that is having high volumetric efficiency. What is having high volumetric efficiency? It is maximum charge induction. We have to do maximum charge induction, okay? Due to this, large inlet and exhaust valves using overheaded valves, okay? This can be achieved by using overheaded valves or multiple valves or streamlining the inlet passage, okay? Due to this, we can decrease the pressure drop, okay? More charge during suction stroke results in increased power output. When a suction stroke takes large amount of charge, due to this input power output increases, okay? How can we increase power output? We can amplify clearance around wall heads, okay? Or we can use large diameter walls, okay? Third factor that induces high thermal efficiency or power output is improved anti-knocking characteristics. We want to improve anti-knocking characteristics, okay? How can we improve anti-knocking characteristics? This is by use of high compression ratio, okay? And this high compression ratio results in increased power output and thermal efficiency. Last factor is a compact combustion chamber, okay? As I explained, compact combustion chamber, due to this, flame propagation speed reduces, okay? Reduce and heat loss reduces. This compact combustion chamber reduces heat loss during combustion and increases thermal efficiency, and as same way high power output is gained. There are different types of combustion chambers, okay? Such as T head type, L head type, F head type, again I head type or overhead wall, okay? There are different combustion chamber designing criteria, okay? For example, maximum volumetric efficiency, as we studied, maximum volumetric efficiency can be obtained with maximum charge induction. Due to this, large inlet and exhaust valves are used, as I said before, okay? Again, minimum flame travel. When minimum flame travel, the heat loss is reduced, okay? This minimum flame travel, which means proper location of spark plug or compact combustion space, okay? Again, minimum heat loss from combustion chamber. This can be achieved when spark plug location is proper, okay? This means less space to volumetric, less surface to volumetric ratio, okay? Again, rate of pressure rise within maximum limit during combustion, okay? Due to this, engine operation will be smooth, okay? And this will show the control rate of combustion of the mixture in an combustion chamber, okay? Again, when we provide or provision of good turbulence, this will increase the rate of burning, and hence the tendency of detonation will decrease. When detonation tendency decreases, again engine speed is, engine performance is good, okay? Again, satisfactory cooling of certain critical parts. As I explained earlier, satisfactory cooling of exhaust valve is necessary, as it is hottest region on combustion chamber. Again, piston crown or spark plug, electro terminal, this all equipment should be cooled satisfactorily, okay? again good scavenging arrangement, okay, so as to expel products of combustion that may remain in clearance space. The combustion products which remain in clearance space should expel out of combustion chamber. Okay, how can this be accomplished? This can be accomplished with minimum or no short circuiting of fresh charge. Short circuiting of fresh charge in combustion chamber will reduce the time of expelling of combustion remaining combustion mixture. Okay, these all criteria are to be considered while designing combustion chamber of SI engine. Okay, as SI engine, combustion chamber should be designed properly. Due to this, it affects knocking tendencies of an engine as well as engine's performance is also affected by this. Okay, combustion chamber is space where combustion of fuel takes place, and this space is enclosed generally with piston crown or cylinder head and surface cylinder with piston. When it comes to TDC at combustion chamber, okay, this space is almost equal or slightly greater than clearance volume of engine. This is point we must keep in consideration. Okay, in next lecture we will see different types of combustion chambers. Thank you.